Hello friends, this is your teacher Manish, and in this video I am going to start with introduction to software project management. So getting into details, let me first define what project is, and you need to understand it very clearly. A definition of project is: a project is a temporary endeavor to create unique product or service. Just note that I am not mentioning software here. I am mentioning project as a generic term. So a project is a temporary endeavor. Endeavor here means aim. So I have a temporary aim to create a unique product or a service. So my aim can be building a house. My aim can be building a multi-story mall, right? So at the aim, what is the outcome of my aim? I have a house, right? The word temporary here is very, very important. Just understand, what does it mean? Temporary means that every project is definite. It has got a fixed start and end date. There is no project which is ongoing. So every project which starts need to end at some point of time, and ideally need to end within the timeline that is planned. Okay. Then what is project management? So project management actually is nothing but application of knowledge, skills, tools and techniques to project specific activities in order to meet or exceed stakeholder needs or expectations from the project. So let us understand it in more detail. Every project, be it a building of a house or a software development, it will have number of activities that need to be done. So let's take the example of building a house. So it starts right from the time of acquiring a plot on which one needs to raise a house, then getting the plan sanctioned from local council or municipal corporation. Once the plan and design is sanctioned, the architect signs it. After that, collecting the resources, buying all necessary raw material, putting the manpower, and then civil engineer and his team taking it to conclusion, right from digging the base to putting up the ceiling. So all those activities, okay, needs to be managed. And how are those activities managed? By putting knowledge, skills, tools and technique. A civil engineer, probably, who is going to be a manager of that particular project, will put his experience, will put his knowledge, will put his skills, okay, will get required tools, will get required techniques, resources to take those project activities to completion. And here, completion means completing as per the expectations of customer. And in 21st century, customer always wants something more than what he has asked for. And hence, the word over here is exceed stakeholder needs and expectations, where stakeholder here is a customer. Okay. And this means you will immediately understand that it's not an easy task. Project management is not an easy task. And it involves balancing between scope, time, cost and quality. So let us now understand what each one of these attribute or parameter is. So what's a scope? A scope is something which defines what is needed, right? So what is needed? In terms of software, it would be the requirements of customer. So if a software development needs to develop a ERP application, then what is the scope of ERP application? What modules of ERP are required? Is it HR, finance, time office, payroll? If these are different modules, then which are the modules? Within each module, what are the different features that are required? What is different functionalities that are required? So complete breakdown of requirements is nothing but the scope. Okay. Next is time. So what's the fixed start and end date? When do I start the project? And what is my final delivery date? Am I going to deliver my project in phases? Or am I going to deliver it everything together? What is the plan? So time is very, very important. It is the most crucial commitment. Cost. Cost is nothing but what is my budget? What is the cost for all the resources that I am going to put in? And these resources are manpower resources. They can be non-manpower resources. So in terms of IT project, procuring a server, procuring a hardware, procuring network elements, procuring you can say different devices, can be non-resource cost, whereas resource cost would be actually deploying designers, deploying coders, deploying testers. So whatever efforts they are going to spend, because anyway when you deploy a team, the team you don't get free of cost, right? You have to pay them. So their salary becomes your resource cost, and the total cost of your project would include all non-resource and resource cost. So your people as well as your infrastructure, your electricity, your office space, your travel, so everything inclusive becomes your cost. And last but not least is the quality. So remember one thing, why I say it's a balancing, because if you increase time, your cost gets increased. If you increase scope, your time gets increased, obviously your cost increases, right? If you try to deliver additional scope without increasing time, you might compromise into your quality. And why I say so? Because without adding additional resources, without adding additional people, coders, designers, you have increased your scope, you have added the functionality without actually increasing the timeline. And that is going to impact on your quality, because you are going to make your people overwork. You are going to call them over the weekends. Instead of 8, 8.5, 9 hours of daily work, you are going to make them work for 12, 14 hours, and that's going to impact your quality because they are going to do mistakes. And hence, as a project manager, these four things become increasingly important, and balancing them is one of the most important activity of a project manager. Okay, so just understand what does a project means, its definition. Yeah, it's a temporary endeavor to create a unique product or service meaning of word temporary, okay, what's unique, and then also understand what exactly project management means. Okay, project management is nothing but the application of knowledge, skills, tools and techniques to project activities in order to meet or exceed stakeholder needs and expectations from the project. And this all needs a huge balancing of scope, time, cost and quality. We'll be getting into greater details of this. So let me explain how scope, time, cost and quality are dependent on each other, and how project manager needs to play a balancing act between them. So let's take an example. Okay, so we have a project team of say 15 software engineers. They are very skilled, high-end engineers. They can do multiple tasks like design, development, testing, and they are currently deployed to do enhancement, say for example on a software application which is meant for financial aspects of an organization. So it's a financial application, and this enhancement, say for example, comprises of 15 requirements. So they need to add 15 new features within the application. So I would say we have 15 resources, we have 15 new features to be added. Okay, so my cost is nothing but the salary of 15 software engineers. My scope is, say for example, 15 requirements, and my timeline, I need to do it in 2 months, month one and month two. So 15 engineers will work for 2 months to enhance the software and add additional 15 features or 15 requirements. Now, customer comes and says, well, I want to add additional 5 requirements. So my now scope changes to 20 requirements, and customer comes and says, but I don't have additional budget. So those 20 requirements you need to do within 15 software engineers. Well, as a project manager, I start thinking, and I will go back to customer and say, well, fine, I can do that, provided you give me additional 1 month, right? So instead of 2 months, I take 3 months, I use 15 software engineers and deliver 20 requirements. But customer says no, because there is some mandate which is given by government, and you need to complete those requirements and deploy the software live within 2 months. And that's where the problem starts. So you have increased the scope, but you have got constraints, and those constraints are delivering within same number of software engineers within same timeline. And I have no choice as a project manager. So what will I start doing? A, I will ask these 15 software engineers to work round the clock, 2 shifts. Is it good? Of course not. So what is the second option? Second option, well, I would start looking at certain activities which I can start reducing. Can I decrease the scope of testing? Can I try to give it in phases? Which are the priority requirements? Can I make the delivery in two phases, in which I first deliver 15 requirements which are topmost priority in 2 months and 5 more requirements in an additional month with less resources? I need to go on thinking in terms of how can I start delivering this additional scope within the specified time. And that's where the compromise of quality might happen. So if you enhance the scope without increasing the team or without increasing the timeline, then you are going to compromise the quality. Unless you have estimated or budgeted some buffer within your overall estimation, okay, and then within which you can absorb that piece of work. But typically, no software manager or no customer will allow you to keep that buffer. Okay, so this is a classic example which I thought I will share with you in order for you to understand how these four parameters are linked with each other and how a software engineer of how a software project manager need to balance between those. Okay. If you see traditional project management, when I say traditional project management, I mean project management in non-software industry, okay, is very well mature, has got all the processes well set. The engineering activities within those processes, be it manufacturing, be it any other vertical, are very well measured. Software industry is relatively young. So when I say this, software industry would be probably say 5 decades old, around 45-50 years. And within this period, technology has changed so rapidly. Say for example, if somebody has built a house 15 years ago and wants to now build another house today, there won't be much difference within the activities that probably were carried out 15 years ago and what are going to get carried today. Hardly any resources, both in terms of manpower or non-manpower. When I say non-manpower, it would be raw material. You would still require bricks or cement blocks, you would still require cement, you would still require steel. All that has remained same. But imagine if somebody has developed an ERP 15 years ago and somebody is planning to develop an ERP now, there's going to be an immense difference. Yeah, 15 years ago probably it would have been a client server, web-based ERP. Today it's going to be mobile enabled. All devices should be able to, you know, kind of access the ERP modules. So there is going to be immense difference. People who were 15, or the skills of the engineers or software developers 15 years ago and skills required today with the kind of open source, freeware, plug and play, integration world. A lot of difference. Okay. So software project management is relatively challenging, relatively difficult as compared to traditional project management in other verticals. Another most important thing is software is a brain product, no doubt about it. It is more people dependent, it is more skill dependent, it is more knowledge dependent. And when it comes to managing knowledge, managing skills, managing people, it poses huge, huge challenge. Every software which gets developed changes based on the customer requirements. Or rather, I would put it like this: every customer has their own requirements. They expect software to be developed in such a way that their processes, which are more custom and made for them, needs to be automated. So there are huge amount of challenges in software project management. So I typically say, take this a triangle. So your software development has got software development or software project management has got three sides. One is people, another is process, and third is technology. People collaborate with each other. You have numerous stakeholders. You have engineering teams, developers, testers, designers, architect. They collaborate with each other. You have numerous technologies that get used, which need to be integrated. So in today's world, it's not like you give an end-to-end solution for everything. You rather have something developed which is in Java technologies, something else developed in some other technology. Both the applications talk to each other, and both together gives a solution to a customer. Okay, so you need technologies which integrate with each other, which talk to each other. And of course, you need a process. Process, software engineering processes, software development life cycle. Your life cycle can be a waterfall model. You might have a spiral model. In today's world, everybody wants to follow agile model. So you need to follow those processes. So overall, these three sides are very, very important. And these three sides form a triangle, which I can say is a software project management triangle. They need to work with each other to deliver a successful software. In next video, I am going to speak about challenges of software project management. And I am going to also touch base upon software project management as a science or arts. So till then, thank you.